What's going on, Deep Dive Spear crew? Brock here, up here on this cold December morning. I've been doing a lot of boat projects. This video probably won't come out till like February, but I'm gonna take you through the entire process of making smoked deer sausage. You can see hanging behind me here, I've got a doe that I harvested yesterday. I'm gonna video that, so if you're a little squeamish, you may wanna fast forward a little bit, but I'll show you everything from cleaning the deer to processing the meat down to small cubes, to running it through the grinder, mixing it with fats, mixing it with spices, and actually smoking the sausage all the way through the finished product. It'll take a little while to produce this video, but y'all stay with me. Well, first of all, cleaning deer. There are several different ways, many ways to clean deer. Some people prefer to hang them by their head and clean them from the top down. And some people hang them like I have this one on the back legs, on this single tree or gambrel, whatever you want to call it. Which way's right? I don't know. My dad taught me how to do this 40 years ago, and I've cleaned many, many a deer just like this. One thing that I do see that people do wrong is they get so much hair on the meat. Once you get the hair on the meat while you're cleaning, it's really hard to get it off when you're washing. And so it's much better to try to avoid getting the hair on there. So the first thing you'll see me do is actually wring the back legs right here. I'll make a small incision and then start wringing it from the inside out. I don't cut the hair into the meat. And then I try to work with my knife under the skin from the inside out for most of the clean. Now, it doesn't get all 100% of the hair. Sometimes it gets on there, but at least it's not small little cut up pieces. And if you talk to a deer processor, a lot of times people come with just hair all over their meat. Deer processors, they're not gonna clean your meat real well. I once went to a deer processor and he looked at the guy brought in a bunch of meat with hair on it, and he says, "I'll grind your meat up, but it's gonna have all that hair in it." And the guy looked at him like, "What do you mean?" He says, "I don't clean deer meat up. Look at that boy's over there." And he showed mine, and it was nice and clean, no hair on it. So a little bit of patience, a little bit of, little more work on the front end saves you on the back end when you don't have to try to get all the hair off this meat. All right, here we go. That's the little bit of hair that I'll get on there. I'll make that one small incision. And then I put the tip of my knife in and try to work from the underside out. And also on the back right here, there's a tendon that attaches right here. You don't want to cut that or the deer will fall on you. Then you'd be in a mess. So make sure you got a good sharp knife. One of the worst enemies while cleaning the deer is having a dull knife, just because you'll stab yourself trying to hack through stuff. Whereas with a good sharp knife, you'll cut it and you won't necessarily hurt yourself. Now, growing up, I cleaned deer without gloves on. Tens of deer, hundred deer. Nowadays, I try to wear gloves. If I have them, I don't necessarily have to have them. So I got that ring around it, and I take my knife, insert it right here, and come down to the middle. Get under her skin. So I'll peel the skin back right there, and I'll grab this edge, and I'll start working this around with my knife. Do the other side the same way. Doesn't have to be a beautiful cut. Now I've got these two right here. I'll connect them right here. This being a doe right above her mammary glands. A little bit of milk still in her. Take this flap of skin and work it back until it lays over. And lays over behind her. I said I try to keep my knife tip free of hair and out of the meat if I can. You're not going to avoid it 100%. One thing you got to be watch out for, that's her bladder. It's got urine all in it. You do not want to pierce that and get that all over your meat. Some people, they'll take and core it out with a knife. I just leave it alone. because I deboned the deer actually off of the carcass while it's hanging. I don't cut the bones and saw them and all that stuff. It's just much easier just to debone it while it's hanging, and I'll put it in the bin over there. I'm kind of squeamish, you might not want to watch this part. You take the hide and roll it up a little bit, and it'll just peel down. And on this doe, I actually gutted her last night, and it was below freezing, so I just let her hang till this morning. If I'd have harvested her and cleaned her with the guts still in, a lot of times I do that. A lot of times I don't even gut them. I just do the same process like I'm doing right here, but slit the skin right here along the abdomen all the way to right here, and then I'll just peel it down and just leave the guts aside. From this point, I just start deboning it. I'll start right here with the back straps. Make sure your knife is clean. And you ain't got any hair on your gloves or your hands either. This right here, their backbone runs right here. This back strap runs from the top of their hip all the way to right where their front shoulder is, the wither, front shoulder. Insert your knife right along here. Come right down the backbone, just let your knife tip follow it. Cut it at a 90 degree angle right here to the hip joint. Take your knife and insert it this way, and you start your cut like this. Grab here, take the tip of your knife, cut the back of it out, start the back from peeling down. Try not to leave any meat, because I'm sure you spent countless hours preparing your food plot, putting out some attractant. Hours in the stand, which we don't spend near as many hours in the stand as I used to growing up. Not only because I'm not mad at the deer anymore, but game cameras that have cell phone signals, I got where I just don't even go unless there's something on my camera. Is it cheating? I just think it's more efficient. You can be more selective and prioritize your time better. So I'm just gonna peel this right down. Basically, you just kind of cut in a U-shape, just follow your ribs and your backbone right there, the vertebrae. Try to get all the meat you can. All the way down to the inside of the shoulder blade right there. Far down as you can get with your knife. A lot of times what I'll do is this silver skin disconnects up here. And so I'll take my knife and I'll cut through the meat but leave the silver skin attached. So I can peel that silver skin off and just leave it attached to the carcass. Do the other side the same way. Take the front shoulders. Got meat right here on the inside. You shoot them right here, it'll mess it up. So if you can, try to shoot them somewhere else. So this deer was facing me, so I actually shot her in the chest. And so it didn't really mess any of the meat up, thank goodness. Nice hunk of meat. Got a few hairs on it, but we'll clean that up. Yeah. try to get as much as you can off of there. Be wasteful. That right there is going to be ground up. So once I get to that point, what I'll do, you can visualize the bone structure, the leg bone going down right here to their tailbone, and this hip, I just kind of core it out. So I take my knife in the center and I'll pierce until I touch the, I'm tapping on the bone. I'll come down to the middle like that. And I'll start ringing around just like this. You see the cut? I just follow the structure of the bone right there. Make sure that's good and separated. Get up under it. Now take them come this way. See if we get where you can see. And I'll just follow the bone. Separate it from the bone. So there's one half of your hindquarter. Then I'll do the same thing for the other side. Go ahead and cut down. Follow the bone. Cut that loose. Then I'll do this side. Don't cut too close to this tendon up here, otherwise your deer, the carcass will kind of fall on you. I got that. And then what I'll do, I'll come back and salvage this little hunks and eat. For making sausage. Oh shoot, drop that one. Make sure you hold on to it, because it's nothing like a party foul like dropping that beautiful meat into the dirt. Yeah, there are some other things you could do with the rest of the carcass. Some people cut all the rib meat, like you can cut in between the ribs. Cut those hunks of rib meat out. There's just not really much there. It's just so thin, and deer is so lean that whenever you cook it, it dries out. So I guess you could make some jerky out of that if you wanted to, but it's pretty thin even for jerky. So that's really what I do. Debone it on there. I'll come back and clean this up a little bit more. But that's the deer, I guess the cleaning process, that's the rough clean of the deer. Next thing we'll do is actually cut up the meat, clean it up good, and then cube it up and weigh it so we know how much we have to start with sausage. I don't have any Ziploc bags, but I do have some brand new ice bags, so I'm going to use that. So what I'm going to do is cut all the silver skin off, cube it up into about 1-inch cubes, put it in my bag. I got a set of scales in there, and I'll weigh it. I'll go ahead and write the weight on there, and you'll see why I do that later. It just saves a bunch of time. You know, you do a lot of work on the front end to save you time on the back end. So at this point, I'll make sure I pick any hair off that I see. I'll cut down. Just cut it in chunks. Cut any fat or silver skin off that you see. I'll take something like this. Cut it about that size right there. That's what my meat grinder likes, about that size right there. And take that, throw it in the bag. So I'll work this entire pan down, just like that. And we're done. That was only about 30 minutes worth of cutting up. Got two bags full of cubed meat, ready to go weigh it, mark it, and put it in the freezer. And when you get ready to smoke next month, we need to harvest another deer or two, add that to it. Usually I'll smoke about 25 pounds of link sausage for my family, and I got a couple buddies, they'll smoke some more also, smoke some of theirs also, but I'll show you my smokehouse when we get around to that. Usually 75 to 100 pounds of link is what I do at one time. It's a lot of work not to do that, it's a lot of work to just do a little bit, so you might as well do a lot whenever you're doing it. Stay with us. Well, it occurred to me that I haven't explained why I'm laying it. Whenever you're making deer sausage, deer is so lean that you actually have to mix pork fat with it, otherwise it would just turn dry and burn. And so I have to weigh these bags so I know how many pounds of deer meat I'm mixing with how many pounds of pork fat. I do a 70-30 mix, 70% deer meat to 30% pork. A lot of deer processors do an 80-20 mix. To me, that's way too dry. But you know, I found just over the years that 70-30 is just a lot juicier. It's a better sausage. People enjoy it more. And so that's what I do. So I take my digital scale right here, turn my units to pounds, and weigh them out. And I'll write it on the bag so when I get ready to actually smoke the sausage, I'll know how much I have in each bag so I get my ratios correct. That is 7.4 pounds. I'll write it on my bag so I can see it. 7.4. Another one is, units changed on me. That is 4.4 pounds. It's not a whole lot of meat rendered from a adult doe, but you got to remember the majority of the weight of an animal on the hoof is their internal organs. I think if I take 1,100 pound steer that you may process, 62% of that is edible meat. The rest of it is bone, hide, things like that. And so a deer is much the same. A lot of their hoof weight is actually internal organs and things like that. And so whenever you do this kind of process, and your yield isn't really a whole lot. But like I said, you got to trim it all down. If you leave the sinew in it and also the deer fat, then your deer fat, because of what they eat, it's a kind of a gamey taste. And so our palate, for Americans, is really geared toward pork and beef, and so that tends to be what people mix deer meat with to get the flavors that we're accustomed to, and that's why I weigh it. All right, y'all, we got a special guest here on the channel today, one of the original crew members. We got Brandon, the B-Dog. He's done popped him a young doe, young nanny. We always We always smoke sausage together because it's a family event, family affair. It's hard to just smoke sausage for one person. You need to combine a few people and a few families, and you can smoke 7,500 pounds of sausage at one time. Then that makes you worth your time. Got a little Merle Haggard playing in the background. Can't beat this.